Well, good evening, and here we are talking about one of the greatest artists, contemporary artists, living today, and finally, because we call him from New York, the place where we are today, in the Guggenheim Center, the conference hall, and we will talk about the artist Marigliano. But we start with the professor Romano Romadè, because he asked us, because last time he was not really happy about his critics, he prepared some new notes about, and he will tell us what is going today with the art, with the contemporary art, and with this brand new artist from Italy. Well, first of all, thank you very much, because it's a pleasure for me to be Guggenheim Hall Center Conference. I started very fast, because I want to be clear, this time, last time, I was not really concentrated. Some figure very fast passed me through, and I didn't add the brilliance and the certain of a genius like he is, and like we are talking this artist today. Well, I start beginning saying that few figures in the history of the art of all times has given birth to a poetic world so manifold. Attention, manifold, no manigold. Manigold is not something else in its aspect. So contrasting, so open to every lyrical and like a music, no? A human dimension of the artist Marigliano. The artist has been deeply involved, is deeply involved in European artistic events since he had the experience of living the art of a figurative culture to the fullest from 300 until Pablo Picasso. Studying itself too, because he did everything alone, no, because actually started as musician. Understanding, he understand art, and then offering the world of today, and we are very glad. His new artistic language, which obviously appeals richer to Gamme, I'm sorry, his new artistic language, which obviously appeals richer to Gamme. The artist, Marigliano, was however the son of his land to the point of identifying himself totally without reservation, with the very soul of his Italy and his South, with his passion, his restlessness, because he never went to sleep. The sleep is first for life and his daring challenge continues to his multiple creative expressions. Absolutely. Italian, certainly this artist, but also European. This artist was surely with equal consistency the son of two centuries, the 900 and the terzo millennio. Nothing of the mischievous grace and the joyful lighter temperness, of the irony and satire typical of our days, has remained unknown to him. Unknown. Since the times of the first decade of the new century, the artist is matured in few solitude with respect to contemporary culture, that poetic vision that for immediacy of feeling and modernity of language anticipated with surprising certainty the greatest revolutionary artistic currents of the new century. In such an extraordinary evolution, it is immediately possible to trace the terms of a current artistic vision, a guiding thread, the constant that is given to us above all by the artist's attitude towards reality. Reality is first inspiration. He establishes an instinctive and passionate direct contact with it, but the image that he gives us in his work is always subjective, transfigured by his personal vision, as in this moment, and yet never mediated by intellectualistic meditation, At certain point, also Jobim asked him, "How? What are you doing?" And he said, "No, this is a different meditation, even in Tibet." Artist of reality, he does not photograph, not even with the Polaroid. Does not transcribe, but recreates the world that he feels and that he lives, as he wanted to recall the sound of his abandoned instrument. And that's pity. To undertake this new and exciting artistic adventure, I think he needs a new mouthpiece. For this reason, his works are revealing of his personality at least as much as of the subject personality. For this reason, his symbols and monsters have the concrete, striking evidence of all that is totally alive. Well, Professor Romano Romades, very interesting, but please, I see that you wrote some final notes. Please go on and then we conclude with coffee break. Thank you very much. This artist offers a precise constant also in the tenacious and progressive revolution that leads against the formulas, the convention, the preordinated systems that govern the contemporary art of his time. This constant is conducted in a completely different direction from the avant-garde and neoclassic movement in the name of the freedom of the art of frank and instant artistic expression and an already romantic individuality. Finally concluding, this artist affirms the right to express with his art a personal reality that restores body to the feelings, anxiety, uncertainties, confused disturbance of the unconscious, like Freud was telling us in the early 1900s, without resorting to exemplary schemes, I'm sorry, where in this extraordinary task there is only guide to his beautiful intuition. Well, Professor Romano Romades, very beautiful script. You did this. Well, I was talking with Professor Ritorta and I did the translation, but I agree with what he says, so I did this for this. Okay. Well, Professor, thank you very much. Let's have a coffee break. Thank you very much. You're welcome.